What's up, guys? Duarte here with another Marvel Strike Force video. And in this video, we are going to take a look at that over there, at that 1 million power team, and see how exactly you can defeat it with a almost 400k punch up with a mediocre, very mediocre Eternals team. But once again, we are here to prove that if you use your brains, you don't have to use your wallet. At least not to the point where you have to break your bank account. Okay, so like always, if you like the video, make sure to smash that like button. If you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe for more Marvel Strike Force content and something else. If you are thinking about the live streams, I will start once again next week. I'm starting to feel a little bit better, so every Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday at 8 p.m. European Central on YouTube. Okay, so with all that said, first let's take a look at my team and then the T4s I have and so on, and then take a look at this madness. The first ever 1 million team, at least on my arena shard, I don't know, in other places. So let's check it out. Okay, so these are my Eternals, and right now they are a lot stronger than they were in that video. We already have Blue Iso, and we have one character at G-tier 13, the other at G-tier 14. Both of them are at level 75, but I cannot remember exactly if in the video they were or not. I think just one of them. In terms of Iso 8, I'm using Icarus as Raider, and I'm using Cersei as a striker. I will make a video in the future talking about their ISO 8 and why I'm using like this, but it's not important. If you have the standard skirmisher and the striker, it should be fine as well. But this is a little bit more interesting because of the way it works. So nothing special about them in terms of gear and levels, as you can see. The ISO 8 is also the standard. We have level 3 on the sockets, but only level 2 on the ability. In terms of the T4s, I have the ultimate and the passive. The passive is not necessary at all, to be honest. Only the ultimate matter for this specific situation. And in terms of Cersei, you really want to use her ultimate. The passive, is, if I remember correctly, it gives extra focus, so that's important. And the special, it's not super important, but it kind of helps. Getting that 25% extra damage, it kind of helps as well. And then we have the 10% barrier. So as you can see, my Eternals are literally nothing special. And still, in the video, they were worst. And even at this point, it enables crazy, crazy matches if you know exactly what you are doing. So using your brains rather than your wallets. Okay, so we are going to take a look at the match. We are not going to take too much look into the team I use because it's pretty obvious after looking at the match. And there is a counter for the team I'm using, but I'm going to save that counter for a future video because if I put every single detail, then there is no content to make, of course. So therefore you have to come back later for more good information and good strategies. Okay, so let's get started and take a look at the video. Okay, so here we go against my friend, not friend, I never talk with him, but with a gorilla. He changed his name in the past, but he's back. He's back with his OG name. And we are going to face him. The first 1 million account on my arena shard, 1 million team on my arena shard. And the team we are using, it's the Eternals, of course, Captain America Sam Wilson, or Falcon 2.0, Emma Frost, and Doctor Doom. So this is the team we are using. There is a team that can counter this one, like I said before, check it out in the future. And in terms of ISO 8, we have the Striker on Cersei, we have the Raider on Icarus, Fortifier level 3, on Falcon, and we have Doctor Doom with the level 3 Striker, and Emma, she's level 5 maybe with the Fortifier. So let's get started and let's take a look at this match. As you can see, the power of the team is 600 and 30,000, and we are punching up almost 400k. It's what, 375, something like that. It's pretty close. Okay, so we are getting started, and because of the turn meter, we'll go first. And this is the most important thing about eternal matches, is who goes first. If you go first, your Icarus, especially if Cersei has the focus on the passive, the additional focus, then you'll have higher chance of flipping all of those positive effects into negative effects, including defense down. Now, you have to be very, very careful with Dr. Doom. If you focus on him, you are going to lose. You need to focus on the other characters. Now, let me know in the comments, why are people using Kestrel? Why so many people are using Kestrel? Because Kestrel is trash. Kestrel is not good on Arena. Silver Surfer, I kinda maybe understand, not really. But why? Why these two characters? It makes no sense. And this is why we win against this team, because they are using their wallets and not their brains. It's not because the team is 1 million power that will not get destroyed by our team that is almost half of their power. Okay, so let's get started. Of course, we are going to use the ultimate. And like I said, don't focus on Dr. Doom. Then we are going to use the ultimate of Cersei. And look at how small. She was level 70. Gear tier 13. Oh my god, ridiculous. 5 yellow stars, 4 red stars. Humiliation. Okay, so look at this. Dr. Doom is almost at 50% HP, no problem. Kestrel, she is almost gone, and she'll be gone pretty soon. And now we are going to get turn meter. But isn't that going to activate the passive from Dr. Doom? Yes, but no problem. Because we are going to slow Dr. Doom. Look at that. Just that tiny, tiny little bar there, we are going to slow it. And ours has the same tiny bar, but we are going to get extra speed because we are slowing them. So we go first. And because we go first, look at that. Special in the face. Now, you can also do the ultimate early on if you get the energy there. That's even easier, but it's unnecessary. Now, the reason why there is no point on doing the special T4, it's because there is no, you have no reason to use it. You might you just use the basic. And this one, the special, it's pretty good just to make sure that it gets deleted no matter which character gets the assist. Unfortunately, it was Emma Frost, otherwise he would be deleted. Now use the ultimate and 400k punch up. And that's how we roll. Easy. Easy, very, very easy. Okay, now just for the lulls, we put on times one speed and we win, just like that. Almost 400k punch up. Did we need to break the bank? No, not really. We have a mediocre 4 red stars Icarus, 4 red stars Cersei, and 4 yellow stars on Icarus, 5 yellow stars on Cersei. So, as you saw, pretty easy. Is there something else here? No, I don't think so. And that's pretty much it. So yeah, guys, that's gonna be the video. I hope you guys enjoy it. Big punch up against the Eternals in Arena. Don't be scared of the 1 million teams. As you can see, you can punch up very, very easy, even if your team is level 70. Still very, very easy. I hope you guys enjoyed, and if you found information on this video helpful, make sure to share it with your friends on Facebook and Discord. If you are new to my channel, make sure to subscribe for more Marvel Strike Force content. If you are on my Arena shard, please don't attack me, and I will catch you guys later.